Welcome. Today we'll explore named constants in Excel. Previously, we discussed named ranges, which are defined names that reference specific cells or ranges. Named constants, however, are not tied to any particular cell or range. They exist independently and can be used throughout the workbook. This simplifies your worksheet by reducing clutter and allows you to use meaningful names for values, making your formulas more intuitive and easier to understand. Creating a named constant in Excel is simple. Let's demonstrate this with an example. Suppose we have product data with columns for products and price. In the third column, we need to calculate the total price including tax. Assume the tax rate is 30%. Using the formula equals B2*1+30%. In cell C2 calculates the total price, including the tax, and returns the expected value. Instead of directly entering 30% in our formulas, we can create a named constant called tax rate to hold this value. This makes formulas more readable and easier to understand. To create a named constant, go to the Formulas tab and select Define Name. In the New Name dialog box, enter the name tax rate for the constant. Set the scope to Workbook, and in the Refers to field, type equals 30%. Now, let's use the named constant in our formula. Replace the 30% in your formula with the tax rate constant. Excel will automatically substitute the value you defined, making the formula cleaner and more intuitive. Instead of seeing an arbitrary value like 30% in the formula, you'll now see a meaningful name that clearly explains what the value represents. Named constants also make updating values across your workbook much easier. If the tax rate changes, you only need to update the constant's definition, and the changes will automatically apply to all formulas using it. And that's how you can create and use named constants in Excel. If you found this tutorial helpful, don't forget to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and hit the notification bell for more Excel tips and tricks. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.